So, you guys use this for cutting reference or something? I'm not sure what it was for, but...
Yeah, we cut these down to 31 inch, so yeah, that was our...
Yeah, so what I'm doing is making sure that the panels are all facing the same direction, so I'm putting this so it's down.
Oh, okay.
That way the top of the panel, the bigger part's up.
Okay.
I didn't know if it'd make a difference in alignment, but I figured I'd keep them all the same.
Yeah, okay.
So no matter, you know, how you guys cut them, it should
work.
This was on the bottom, everything should
line out.
So we only got two pieces left. Actually, this is my fifth day here.
Okay.
Rethinking that. I think it was only four, but... So I got one day pretty much in trim and 4 days in all the diamond plate that's been put up.
It was like 30 sheets then, yeah?
Do
you know how many feet of it you did, kind of?
32 sheets all together.
Okay,
so,
okay.
By
yourself?
For the most part, I mean, I've had people help me lift it up, you know, especially over the plug, so...
Oh, yeah, when you're fitting around those.
Yeah, okay. Cutouts that we've done. You know,
how did you do the cutouts?
Same thing, just measured them.
Okay.
Actually on the back side.
And then use your grinding wheel?
Yep.
Okay.
Cut them out with
okay.
Grinding.
Okay.
So, anyway, so we got two pieces left. I already measured them. I'm cutting them a quarter short, seeing they get trim. So I'm leaving the quarter pretty much in the middle.
Okay.
Because like you see, they all get trimmed into it, so it doesn't have to be real precise. It's not getting trimmed, as you can see up against the door here, so when I put it, I'm just keeping it tight there.
Okay.
So.
Tied against the tree because you don't have trim there. Yeah,
yeah,
you can go the other way.
Right, yeah. So no,
that's smart.
No trim going right here, but they can...
But it's still clean.
I mean, right, yeah, and I usually put the factory edge against the door in the cut end,
okay,
where it's going to be covered. Then they're going to supposed to caulk that, but looks nice whether they caulk it or not. So anyways, again, determining what the top of the sheet is, which is the bottom.
Okay.
So I usually flip it over.
Okay.
So that's the end. I'm going to measure over my 58 and 1/8 off of. And maybe we just use a starting marker because the board is real nice. 58, 1/8.
Okay.
I usually just put a dot. And then I'm leaving the 4 foot level as a straight edge to mark it.
Beautiful.
That's our piece. So, yeah, again, we're just cutting it with a grinder with a cutting wheel on it. You want to make sure you use your safety gear.
Yeah.
Always use the face shield when using a Metabo. Grinder here. These wheels been known to explode and fly all over the place.
Okay.
So if you want to see some gruesome videos, check out.
I'll back up.
Check out the website that shows accidents.
So I should.
You'll definitely want to wear your safety gear.
Got my glasses.
spur on it. I'll take a file and just knock that down.
Oh, okay.
Just so it's not sharp. So there's no other cutouts in this one for electrical or anything, so we're just gonna move it up and stick it on the wall. And just position it so all that do is stick it up, so the top's gonna be on the body's already where it needs to be, and I'm just gonna roll it right up and stick it to the wall. Using a notch trowel, same one as you use for tile.
Have you done a lot of tile work?
Not a lot, no. I mean, I have done tile work mainly just for self and family. I usually keep the glue a quarter inch back, but since this part ain't getting trimmed, it's going to be right up against there, I'm going to just do a light coat right along that edge just so it sticks real good. A little glue that we get on the floor, I'll just wipe it up later. Before it dries, of course.
Is it a big pain to get up if you let it dry?
Yeah, you'll probably have to use a solvent at that point.
Okay.
But it comes right up with water. So, gonna get that edge real good. And then the rest of them, we'll try to leave about a quarter inch, which is the part that's really gonna get covered with trim anyways. We're just going to cover this 100% with glue and stick it to the wall.
Have you installed the FRP before?
Yes.
How's that compared to this? About the same?
Basically the same. I mean, the same process of installing it all, just different material.
Gotcha.
I
Do you know what they're doing with this place? Do you know what they're doing in here?
It's going to be a place where they revamp forklifts.
Oh, okay.
Silos and forklifts.
Gotcha.
Yeah, so I guess they pretty much go through them and resell them.
Okay.
At least that's what I'm being told. Sort of following my blue line straight across, make sure it's going to hit down here, and stick it to the wall. So I usually get a rag, now that I got glue on my hands, clean up the glue real quick.
Oh, yeah.
And then I just use the rag to make sure I press this nicely against the wall. All the way. They also make rollers for this, but we do not have one. Could be helpful. And any glue that does squirt out, scrape it off.
So that's pretty much done then? I mean, as far as stuck to the wall?
Yep, that's pretty much it. I'll let it dry a little bit.
You don't have to worry about it falling down or anything?
Nope.
Because it's, okay.
No. Should be pretty well stuck now.
That's great. Because then you can kind of massage it into place, yeah? Like if it's a little off right now with the glue, you could kind of...
Yeah, it's tight, but...
It's not like a fastener where you're kind of married to it, yeah.
Right, yeah. I mean, at this point, it would be, if you needed to change something, now would be the time.
Yeah.
If not, after the glue sets up, if, you know, they wanted to change something, I mean, you're pretty much going to be taking out drywall with it, so.
And then can you help explain how you did the lines, like the blue lines over there, and those marks on the top?
Yeah, I just, lasered all that in.
Okay.
So,
and the top line is just for the top of the diamond plate, the blue line, and then
yeah,
the other one is for the trim, right?
The blue line's for the diamond plate, and then
the little marks above
yeah,
it, or
little crow's foots. I did that in pencil because I didn't want to chalk a line on there.
Okay.
So after the trim goes up, he's going to caulk that and then repaint the trim.
Okay.
So those marks won't be shown. I just didn't want.
And then the trim you used was the, what did you use?
MDF. Yeah, it's
okay.
Just 3 1/4 inch MDF, which
okay.
Is going to cover technically about a quarter inch of the diamond plate.
Oh, okay.
So.
Perfect. This is it, huh?
So that's pretty much the process. Then you just step and repeat.
Perfect. Well, appreciate your time.
Oh, yeah.
Mr. Bill.
And, yeah, you guys, I just went through that little sample.